نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن يوم عرفة ويوم النحر وأيام التشريق عيدنا أهل الإسلام وهي أيام أكل وشرب. The day of Arafah, the day of sacrifice, the days of التشريق, these are our Eid people of Islam, and they are days of eating and drinking, which means we should celebrate these days, and also which means the أيام العيد والتشريق not allowed to fast except the day of Arafah. Ibadullah, today is the day of dhikr. Today is the day of thanks. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today is the day of sacrifice. We slaughter our sheep and we enjoy the meat, and also we distribute for our friends and the needy. And the day of sacrifice, this day, the day of Eid, most of the important pilgrimages are done in this day. They do, and they do tawaf al-ifadah, and also they do the sa'i of al-hajj, and also they do for the jamarat, and also last night they were in Muzdalifah. So most of the great deeds for hajj are done in this day. This day also has Eid prayer, what we have done already, and also this is a great deed that we can be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after that we will go and slaughter their sheep, and no doubt this is one of the great deeds in Islam, to shed the blood in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your goat or a camel or a cow. So what a great day, the day of Eid. One of the important things and significant things in the day of Eid is the tawheed. When we repeat the saying of Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Wallahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd, we are declaring the tawheed. Allah is the great, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest. Nothing is greater than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should direct all of our worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say that my salah, my prayers, وَنُسُكِي, my sacrifice, and my life, and also my death, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the greatest deed that we can do, and the most reward we can get from the tawheed. And the opposite, which is the shirk, the worst sin, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. This is the worst sin, and the one who dies with shirk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove all of his hasanat. Brothers, sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his prophet to preach the companions sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, and everyone. And the most important preach and advice is taqwallah, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to achieve the piety, righteousness. The one who follow the taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save himself from the hellfire, will save himself from the temptations and the trials in this dunya and also the akhirah. And that's why the slave should stick to the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean the good deeds, the righteous deeds. And the most important one is as-salah, which is the pillar of Islam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. And we should not be lazy in praying the five prayers every day. And next to that, giving the zakah. This is also one of the pillars of Islam, and also being kind to the parents, and to keep the relationship, the good relationship with our relatives, and also to treat the orphans in a good way, and al-amr al-ma'roof wal-nahi al-munkar, and the other deeds in Islam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave the advice for the companions to listen and obey to the rulers, the Muslim rulers, and not to go against them. You should obey them bil ma'roof, in the good and the known and reasonable thing, in the lawful thing, not of course in the haram things. Because obeying the rulers will make the life will make the life to go straight, and not to have a miss in our country and the countries of Islam. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged the Muslims to be patient. As-sabr ala dhulm al-wula, even the rulers have some dhulm, you have to be patient. Why? Because in Islam will encourage the more benefits even if there is small bad things. And also there is an important thing, which is a dua for the rulers, because if you make dua for the rulers, it means the benefit will be for the whole Muslim ummah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, اسمعوا وأطيعوا فإنما عليهم ما حملوا وعليكم ما حملتم رواه مسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said about how to deal with the rulers if they are oppressors, if they are wrongdoers. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, listen to them and obey them, for on them shall be the burden of what they do, and on you shall be the burden of what you do. Brothers, sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, before leaving the dunya, he made everything clear for us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I am leaving you upon a path of brightness whose night is like its day, which means everything is clear in Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not die before making everything clear for the mankind. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no one will deviate from it after I am gone but one who is doomed. Whoever among you lives will see great conflict. I urge you to adhere to what you know of my sunnah and the path of the rightly guided Khalifa, and cling stubbornly to it, and you must obey even if your leader is an Abyssinian leader, for the true believer is like a camel with a ring in its nose. Wherever it is driven, it complies, which means the Muslim, the good Muslim, always obey if it is sunnah or if it is lawful, and of course if it is haram, he will not obey anyone in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam warned us, وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتُ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, avoid novelties, for every novelty is an innovation, and every innovation is a misguidance. So this is a great nasiha from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this issue, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. And moreover, this is my path, which means Islam, which means the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is my path, which is straight. So follow it and don't follow other ways, for you will be separate from his way. So any way other than the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will take you astray and will take you to the hellfire. Brothers, sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the Eid day, he gave a nasiha for the sisters, for the women. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a great hadith for the woman. إِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَ خَمْسَهَا وَصَامَتْ شَهْرَهَا وَحَفِظَتْ فَرْجَهَا وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا قِيلَ لَهَا ادْخُلِي الْجَنَّةَ مِنْ أَيِّ أَبْوَابِ الْجَنَّةِ شِئْتِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said for the woman, about the woman, when a woman observes the five prayers, fast during Ramadan, preserves her chastity, and obeys her husband, she may enter by any of the gates of paradise she wishes. أقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. أما بعد, brothers and sisters, after our salah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith, إن أول ما نبدأ به يومنا هذا أن نصلي. The first thing that we start in our day, the Eid day, is to pray this Eid prayer. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ثم نرجع فننحر فمن أصاب فمن فعل فقد أصاب السنة. Then after that, we slaughter our sacrifice. The one who did so, then he achieved the sunnah. He is doing exactly like the sunnah. So let's do the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those who like to live with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in paradise to follow his sunnah. Brothers, sisters, enjoy this Eid. The Eid, it is sunnah to celebrate the Eid, to make the others happy, especially your family members. Try to forget any fights with your brothers, with your sisters, with your friends. The dunya is finishing And if you keep a good relationship with your Muslim brothers and you compromise anything with them about the dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in the akhirah. Jazakumullah khair, brothers and sisters. Eidkum barak wa taqabbalallah minna wa minkum.